right. Wild man, Thomas Brodeur versus Henry Brodt. And we are live, baby, live once again. Here at insidepool.tv, the billiard channel, APA. I don't know what that was. On Facebook, what's up? What's going on? Out there. See, we're rocking everybody at work, checking us out. How's the stream looking, everybody? Are you loving insidepool.tv today in the APA? Good. Go over to poolplayers.com as I command you and find your local APA league. Do it now. Sign up, be there. Add some depth to your life. Go out there, talk to people, hang out, play some pool. It'll help you in your life, I promise you. I've played on the APA leagues way back when, and it was very beneficial. I enjoyed it. Now I can't commit to being in one place for more than a week, so as you all know, I'm seeing all them likes flying across the screen and love signs. Send me some love. Love power. Right. Uh-oh. That doesn't make me happy. I'm seeing all them thumbs up flying. Henry Brodt gets ball in hand. Not a bad place to be for your first shot. I only want the love signs from the girls. Guys send thumbs up, girls send love signs. Period. Gasping faces and angry faces. I see a couple of them. Here at Strokers, mystrokers.com. Get here, I command you. You better be here next year. Eat some of these scramps. Thank you. Tom Brodeur. I'll fix it up there. Thank you, Mike from Florida Drone Videos and Inside Pool. Oh, I got a couple love signs. I know there's some girls that have some love signs. All right, Henry Brodt bears down. I know the love signs are for Brian Parks. Hey, we're having a lot of fun here. It's glad to see everybody out there. The chat gets very distracting. I don't want to do that, because then the YouTube trolls.
Why aren't you talking about pool? I don't want to hear about the chat. What are you talking to the chat for? Alvin's the worst commentator ever.
Am I? More than welcome. Nice shot. Henry Brodt is smooth sailing. Ball just barely falls in the pocket speed. All right, Chanel, thank you for sending me love signs. See that? Thank you, thank you. See, Chanel loves me. All right. Henry Brodt is from beyond this world. The way this guy plays, man, wow. Current champion, actually. Boom. See that? He doesn't move the cue ball a lot. Just enough. These tables here are 4.5 by 9. This is a Brunswick Gold Crown 3. And it's been redone here by... I can't remember the guy's name that does the tables here. He's really cool. Does anybody know out on the chat what the guy's name? I'll ask Jose. I want to give him a shout out too, because he's cool. The stream's on the APA Facebook page. What's the name of your pool mechanic guy again? The billiard fitter, folks. He does an amazing job here. What's his name? Yeah, I remember him. He's cool. All right, thanks. Wes Burden, the billiard fitter. Look him up if you're down here. You definitely want to show up down here at Strokers. I love this place. And I eat for free every time I'm here. James L. Eldridge asks, Alvin, how is Jeff Blattel doing? He shoots at 4:30. Well, I believe now it's 4:30. No, it's 3:30 here. Okay, yeah, I don't exist in time. I'm beyond time. So it's hard for me to know. I don't speak that language. That's next round, 4:30. But yeah, these are 4.5 by 9 Brunswick Gold Crown threes. Happen to be my favorite TV table to film in whatever pool hall, because the pockets are very nice. I'm digging the Chinese eight ball though, the Chinese pool table by Star. I did one of their events after the US Open. You're gonna see some of those videos on our YouTube channel as well. But it's a crazy game. Definitely favors the better player for sure. But not as exciting as watching players play in this tournament and on this table. It's just a joy. Oh my gosh, Henry. Sent the cue ball into another dimension. All right. Tom Brodeur from Bristol, Connecticut, age 34. He's been playing since 2003. We're going to watch him break shortly. Started playing pool with his dad, went to Toys for Tots charity tournament, took fourth place, having never played a competitive match before. Lost both matches to Eric Tang, who finished fourth here last year. Played in the 2005 APA Singles 8 Ball in Vegas, and 2015 U.S. Amateur finalist. Wants a shout out to his little girl Lillian. It's her birthday today. She's here, so she can't hear me, but happy birthday, Lillian. Glad you're watching your dad play pool on TV. How cool is that? His playing philosophy is have fun, play smart. His influence in his life are his parents. He prefers eight ball because he believes to be more strategic. Henry Brodt did not fill out a form, so I have no idea where he's from. The chat may know here. Why don't you tell us out there, chat? Yeah, this is the 4:30 round. Mark Gokey said, thank you for drawing me back into time. I slip out so easy between. Yeah, Steve's laptop is on at St. Louis time. I'm looking at Steve's laptop, which is 3:30 there in Missouri. Race is 2-7. Get on a handy dandy graphic up here as Henry works on his run out, picking a part of shots. Hi. Can I have a Coke, please? Thank you. Thanks, Ashley, my future wife. So how do you join something like this? Chris Hook asks. Hook, how do you join something like this? That is the question. Also, on a side note, before I answer that, Rick Tremblay says, Henry is from Laguna Beach, California. Also, Chanel had mentioned that, too. How do you enter this? You go to APA's poolplayers.com website. What's up, Mark? Yeah, you want to come and talk? Come on. Poolplayers.com website, and you can find all about APA, but this particular tournament has a website, too. USAmateurChampionship.com. USAmateurChampionship.com. You can find out all about how to get into your qualifier. As a matter of fact, we're going to sit down here with Mark Mariani from Youngstown, Ohio, correct?
Yep, that's right.
Let's get you fixed up. Good, buddy. That's right by my old hometown. How are you?
I'm doing all right.
Good, thanks. Both of you, good. And how did you, what qualifier did you win? What was the, how much?
I went to the one in Columbus at the eight ball.
I saw that way on a setup.
There was, I think, 55 people and four qualified. So I was one of the lucky four. Tony Rich was another one that qualified. He lost his first match at 10:30, so I think he plays at 9 o'clock today. And there was a Michael Sulkowski Jr. who also qualified. I'm not sure who the fourth person was.
So are you glad to be here?
Yeah. I tried one other time to qualify and didn't make it. I lost in the finals to Kelly Espinosa, good player from Michigan, I think. But, this is great.
All right, let's check out Henry's break. He's gonna, looks like he's breaking from the side. I'm imagining he's gonna break second ball. I'm watching this monitor over here. Let me see here. We have. There it is. Henry Brodt won. Tom Brodeur won. We're racing to seven. It's a fancy little graphic.
Good break. He's
okay. Let's see what's going on.
Very controlled break there.
Let's see what's going on. Okay, did he break the second ball? Obviously.
Yes, he did.
See, and this
very
is
slow and controlled.
I don't like that because of the amount of clusters at that. I think hitting it with a little more speed is the secret. Because this is a bunch of maneuvering here. It definitely is going to train you, and this is where playing straight pool will help you in a situation like this.
Absolutely.
So.
Absolutely. I was seeing the same ball go in the side pocket when I was breaking. I was breaking a little bit harder.
Yeah, I like to spread them a little bit more on that side ball break, but you're almost guaranteed to get a ball whether you hit it medium or hard. But you don't want to hit it too hard because then they go all to the rails and come back into the center.
I haven't spent enough time breaking with the Magic Rack and 8 Ball. I assume they were using the Magic Rack there.
I didn't see. I was typing. And
okay.
I'm one guy. The chat would know. Chat, tell us the answer. Magic chat. That's what I call it. The magic chat. Ashley's said her phone's at 3%. If it dies, she's going to put it on a charger, or he. When I get home, get back to watch it. All right, well, get back as soon as you can, and let us know when you're back. Very important. Okay. Just reading some of the chat comments.
I was looking at the one monitor.
What's
going
on?
I thought he hooked himself, but can't tell.
It's yeah, our camera's on the ceiling. Our three cameras are on the ceiling here. And sometimes the angle you can't quite see. I like no wires on the floor, no cameras on the floor. So I try to wire up
my
setups.
Players appreciate that.
I try to wire up my setups so that everything that's on the was usually be on the floor for anybody else's show is on the ceiling for me. So yeah, I don't want nobody tripping all over wires. Yep.
I don't think he needed to hit that hard. I thought he would have just came up softly and shot the five for the angle to bump up the two and be out.
Did you see how much movements his stroke back side to side his tip what did there? Watch his stroke. It's real wobbly. So, and that's something you develop over time. What's he been playing here? Well, since he's been playing since 2003. He may have been just trying to play a little more funky English on that ball.
Yeah, it looked like he was going a little low outside trying to come up through the stack there. I didn't think he needed to. But
yeah.
These tables are pretty tight, and the balls are so clean. Anytime you hit it hard, percentage goes way down.
Now you play out of, oh my gosh, what's in, don't tell me.
I'm not going to tell you. I want to test your memory.
Yeah, it's Icebreakers.
That's right.
Yeah, that's a great room. The Mooseys. Love those guys.
Yep,
Mike
guys.
And his son, yes. Mike Jr. They got the great white shark hanging from the ceiling.
Yeah, definitely. I keep forgetting it's there.
I was thinking about setting that room up. The ceiling's like 20 foot tall. I think
oh,
I would.
It's bigger.
I used to have to stand on a top of a 15-foot ladder on the very top rung and do all the lighting, all the everything. I don't know how I'm still alive. And then contend with that giant shark on the ceiling too. I remember that. I had to throw wires.
Did you get a picture
up.
Of your head in his mouth?
No, he's too high up there, man. He's 15 feet in the air. That thing's got to weigh 700 pounds or more. It's huge. But. So that's your room there in Youngstown, and you live there. What kind of work do you do?
I'm a software developer.
Okay.
So I'm a computer geek.
Wonderful to know. Make sure to next time
I am not a hardware technician.
Up.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Nice try.
I actually can fix computers pretty good. So, and my super good friend Bryce Eshelman is a super computer genius, so if I ever really get screwed up, I just ask him. He's actually, him and I did the first live stream ever of pool way back in 2002.
I'll tell you something funny. I haven't owned a computer for 10 years. Software developer, I go home, I do not want to be on a computer. I want to do something else.
Absolutely not. It's like I don't play pool after I do these events anymore. I used to be a pool geek, but
it's very deliberate.
It's more dangerous doing this work, actually, than being in the pool room playing
Speak
as a player.
There.
Yeah.
I don't know if you could see the 11 or 13, which is it? That's 11, right?
Yes.
I can't tell. If he can, he could get out. Slightest bit of low, and he could bump that 13 free.
Let's have a look at camera two here. I don't know about
this.
Yeah,
I don't think so.
If anything, he can hit, you know, the absolute edge of this ball.
Play a soft
I don't
safety
think so.
Here.
Yeah, he's going to play rail first.
Soft safety.
Yeah,
that'll
that's
do.
Good. He took away all the lanes. Five ball, though. Five ball. Let's have a look at the center camera here. All right, so he's going to shoot this ball up in the top left-hand pocket. Knock the two out. It's going to go off the six. to the rail and back out. Six will be clear. Two will be clear. He's still got to contend with the three ball.
Do you think he'll try to make it?
I mean, he can make it. Look at this. Look at this angle. I shoot this ball.
Should he?
Why not? The 3 and the 11 are tied up. He's going to get another shot no matter what.
Famous last words.
Or you can shoot some sort of, I don't know what's the safety, though. He's shooting this. What is he doing? He's going rail for. He must not have been able to hit it right. Yeah, I mean, I would have at least got the, I would have split, at least split the 5 out of there. Broke that cluster out. Because Henry's still tied up with the 11-3. Now he's going to break the 3 out of there now. He's getting it out of there. He'll do it off this problem ball he has.
Probably start with the 13.
That's what I'm thinking.
Got a pretty good angle on the 14. You don't have to drill it. Hit it just good enough to come into that 3 and get that 3 to come off the bottom rail and clear out, and then you're home.
Home.
You do remember what home is, right?
No.
How long have you been on the road?
Over a month. Five events I've done. I've not been home.
Must have been too tight getting the ball in between the 13 and the 8 to shoot it down in the corner. So looks like he still has the angle that we were talking about.
You just got to tune right in on this cue ball.
Might have to do
He's
this
too
softer,
far away.
Though. Softer and just get that 3.
Yeah,
he's going to have to go around the house.
You see that, people? You see how he was a little far away from the cue ball with the bridge? It's a tendency to not tune up on the cue ball with the bridge for some reason. I notice it over and over and over again. The pro players, though, they get the cue ball, the tip right on the cue. Even with the bridge, they're cueing up right on the cue ball, right on the cue ball. Oh.
This table is just too fast.
They're super fast, man.
It sneaks up on you.
I was out there.
Sneaks up on you.
I was out there looking at the rails at the second diamond on the long rails.
That extra foot that rolled hurt him.
They're tight. Felt is tight. Look at this reverse bank.
Wow.
Beauteous. Man, you see him doing a little balancing thing there? He was pushing. He was willing that ball with the fifth dimensional power that all champions possess, that everyone possesses. Look at this.
That was a great bank.
Yeah, I like his little, he's got a very unique playing style. Oh, if he had given us a sheet, he could tell us a little bit more about himself. Chat, since I'm dependent on you for knowledge, can you tell us a little bit about Henry's background? And I'll read it off. I'm watching. And if you're just tuning in, you're watching InsidePool.tv and the APA. You're actually watching APA. But they've been gracious enough to have Inside Pool, myself here. Now I'm your wild man.
It's interesting that these players chose not to use the magic rack.
Well, Henry's a classic player. What's that? He don't know about that thing. All right, watch him second ball. Let's see. He's going to hit it nice and slow and cluster all the balls up in the center.
Didn't really hit it slow. It just didn't explode on him.
They hit it a little bit. It's an interesting layout there. Weird.
Same cue ball's in the same spot as it was the last time.
That's what I was talking about last match, or one of the matches before, how watching these 1,000 times, you start seeing the same things happen over and over again with the different breaks. Like how the balls are all parallel to each other, two in sets of two. It's weird. It's like the second ball break, it makes little parallel clusters of balls separated by like a few feet. It's weird. It's crazy, man, I'm telling you. Buddy. Hey, buddy. Make that ball, buddy. Come on, buddy. Dennis Sosie, what's going on? Where are you, dude? Get down here. All right, now, did anybody say anything about Henry? I can't see it, and Henry, buddy.
So where are these players from?
Well, Henry's from California, and Tom Brodeur is from Bristol, Connecticut. Somebody's asking what's inside pool. What is inside
Get
pool?
Get out of your cave.
Well, if you go to YouTube, you can find us, youtube.com/insidepoolmag. We do a bunch of pool videos. We have the billiard channel on the Roku streaming device. You might even have one and you don't even know there's a billiard channel, but there it is. And we printed a print magazine for 10 years. Founder J.R. Calvert, who is no longer with Inside Pool. This is his baby that I'm carrying the torch while he goes on to bigger and better things. And Ron Hoffman as well.
And J.R. last time,
yeah,
I saw
J.R.
him.
Is a great commentator, man. Didn't you think so?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I learned a ton just sitting there with him.
I know, he's a brain, man.
We were commentating on 14-1 down at Derby City, and yeah. Max Eberly was shooting.
I haven't talked to him in years.
That was great. I learned a ton.
Yep.
I learned more sitting there watching that, talking with him.
I know.
Than I've ever learned playing straight pool.
Exactly. I learned a ton from JR, and he's gone on to other things, and he cannot. You know, in order for him to be completely away from inside pool, he's got to be completely away from inside pool. Me, Ron, you know. So Ron Hoffman and I run it now. And trying to carry on the flame. Hopefully doing a good job. Glad everybody's out there. But that's what inside pool is. We're the billiard channel and a multimedia company. Thanks to APA, who was having us here to help run their live stream, which they could handily do themselves. But fortunately, they choose us. But
I wasn't sure what was going to happen there on that breakout.
This one here.
It's just as well that he missed, probably.
This one here is getting interesting now. Okay, so he's going to play the nine ball first.
He might play a safe in here.
No, he's going to play this nine ball. Now there's a lane after he plays the 15. Is it the 15?
I think so.
Yeah, the 15. It'll roll up table. Can't see on this tiny screen. What is that?
He can get just straight enough on that 14 to come down for the 13.
Okay, that's the 14 there. Yeah, 14, 13. And then he shoots the 12 up in the top left-hand pocket or in the side, but he probably wants to get the 10 in the bottom. The 10 and the 11 both go in the bottom left-hand pocket, and then the 8 in the bottom right. What you thinking?
Well, good plan. See how he manages it.
Mm-hmm.
So far, so good.
Yeah, these are methodical players for sure. I'm seeing the chats. The finals was set a couple hours long last year. It was Henry and David Rowell playing, and they're both meticulous, slower kind of players.
See, I think I might actually like drawing back and getting in the center of the table for these last three balls. He's got an angle that's going to put him near the bottom rail.
Huh. Okay. Well, he's got to play the 11 now.
Yep, he's looking good now.
He's going to have to play just right on these balls.
14 goes past the 8, so he should be okay. Right?
Oh, it does? Okay,
I'm
good.
I'm assuming.
I'm thinking, yeah, it does. Let's check out the other angle here.
So as long as he gets
sure.
a little bump on that two, then he can't get hooked by it.
Yep, he's good. But you can't say that with any of these players, because I've seen them where you swear they're going to run out. I mean, it's so obvious, and then they don't. But
he's
I see the pros do that, too.
He's good.
Yeah, Henry. All right, Henry. Show us how it's done, Pops.
How you doing?
Steve. Now they're asking, why is there no payout at this tournament? Well, there is quite a bit of a payout. You get a title, and there's no money, because that would ruin this tournament.
It's an amateur tournament.
It would absolutely ruin this tournament.
Can't call it an amateur tournament if you're going to pay a significant prize.
Yeah, and you do get paid. You get paid with about a $1,000 trophy, for one thing. The title. You get a $500 or $600 hotel room in the best hotel in Tampa, one of them. You get breakfast 2 days, two mornings, full breakfast. You get an offer. Like, what's the entry fee to this?
I think it was 60 if you're a
60 bucks.
Member. 75 if not. So
70 bucks to come here and for all that. Come down to Tampa, November. And I know it's been warm up there. This November, but usually it's really cold this time of year, and it's wonderful being down here. I just stay down here, but
got
other people that come down here and leave.
Got to see a Bucks game last night.
Good. Yeah, it's gorgeous weather. You can't ask for any better.
That's great.
It's the most perfect day every day. So, yeah, we're rocking it out here at Strokers.
I think he made a stripe in the side again.
Plus, you get your name on the trophy forever. U.S. Amateur Championship. First place. Oh, man. Excuse me one second.
Sure.
Hello, buddy.
Okay, so it looks like he's going to come off the bottom rail and probably clip a little bit of the 11, see if he can free everything up. I was wrong. How you doing, sir?
How you doing? I'm Steve.
I'm Mark.
Alvin took a step out for a second. Steve's coming back in. What's going on in chat? 400 views. Oh, my gosh, guys. Share the stream. King Henry is playing. What are you doing? Get it together, chat. We have a question from chat. What level do you have to be to play here? There's not a requirement that you are a specific skill level or anything like that, but you do have to go through a preliminary round to get here. And then, of course, you got to be able to hang with these guys in these rooms. These are not – these are good players. I mean, a lot of these guys are definitely 7 and 8 ball, 9 and 9 ball. They want a preliminary tournament to get here, and it's not easy. It's not easy.
Definitely not. Definitely not. I would be surprised if there was anybody here that was not a maxed out skill
7
level.
Or 9, yeah, for sure. Let's just say I'm a skill level 3 on a good day, and I'm pretty sure I would never go back to the table after. Like, these guys make it look easy, and they're playing against other 7s and 9s, so even then, I mean, I'm a photographer. I'm walking around taking photos. It's not uncommon for me to have to wait at a table for 20, 30 minutes because one player isn't letting the other player get back to the table. And poor little me has to wait there to take a photo of each player. But it happens pretty often, I would think, in this room. And it's no offense to the player sitting down. Like, if a guy's running racks, he doesn't ever let you to the table. There's nothing you can do.
Absolutely.
You know, you can't do anything from sitting down. So very, very few forced errors walking around the room.
A little nerves here and there. I mean, these guys are nervous too.
I actually think on the TV table especially, you're going to see more unforced errors than you are in other parts of the table because those lights are bright. Like, you know you're on the TV table when you're out there. And it gets a little hot under those lights. Not super. It's not uncomfortable, but it's not a comfortable bar room. Plus, we have a There's a bunch of people watching, you know, thousands of people are watching you online, analyzing every little mistake, you know, armchair quarterbacks that go, oh, man, why do they do that?
At this level, these guys don't expect to make most of the mistakes that they make. So if you're on the TV table, you're even more embarrassed.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Then it messes with your head.
It can. You know? It certainly can.
So, like, this morning we saw a match between a 19-year-old young man versus Brian Park. So it's his first time in the tournament. He's 19 years old. His first round, first match is against Brian Parks on the TV table. I'm like, sink or swim, come on in.
Welcome to the U.S. Amateur.
Right. And I credit to that young man. He had composure. He took a couple of racks from Brian, and I was actually, you know, very well composed. So hats off to that young man. But if you watched that match earlier, it's pretty good. It's pretty darn good. So I'm a skill level 3. You're going to have to tell me what's going on this table.
All right, well, Henry played a safe. He left his opponent up table and without a direct view of the one ball, I think. I don't think he can see the one ball.
Ouch. Question from the chat. Samantha Bryant says, why is this the only table being streamed? Samantha, when you're in an environment like this, it's difficult to set up multiple cameras and to get them all switched around. We actually have 3 cameras, and they're all hung on the ceiling. So a lot of it's logistics. You know, we're not like a lot of time when you watch stuff on TV, they're on closed sets and things like that, so they have a lot more opportunity with rigging. Alvin actually is the one that come and did it all for us. You should see how we've got the cameras. So it's not as easy as you might think.
Great hit there, and great return on his investment there. He left his opponent. He left Henry tough. Henry's looking to play a safe up table again.
Jeff, the camera can barely see table 4. It doesn't give a good view of table 4. So, and it's not something we can just go turn around, because we do need to respect the players in the pit. Obviously, we don't want to be distracting. For us to get back in there and turn a camera, we'd have to bring a ladder, and that's just not going to happen. Okay. Here's a question for you. Why wasn't the safe shot on the 5 a ball in hand? Did you catch that? I may have been talking too much.
Well, it was a legal shot.
I guess that's the answer there. It was a legal shot. That's why it's not a ball in hand.
Well, wait a second. Now, Henry is stripes. So he shot his stripe into the ball to combo the 5, and that's why he hit his object
ball first,
right.
Which
and
caromed
then,
into
and
the
he pocketed okay. his opponent's ball. In this tournament, you have to hit your ball first, and then something has to go in a pocket or
a rail.
Hit a
right?
rail.
Yeah.
So he met all his requirements, and that's why that was a legal shot.
Jeff Turabaz, have we considered PTZ cameras? Yes, actually, for those that don't know, a PTZ camera is a pan-tilt zoom. And we're actually looking into getting some of those for our national events in Vegas. So we'll see how that goes. We're
what
also looking into get a telestrator. So what a PTZ camera is, it's something that hooks in the thing, and you can actually control it with it's like a video game,
okay.
And you can zoom in on stuff.
Okay,
that
I
might
see.
Be something in the future. Probably not something that we would bring out here again. You have to mount these things.
I think I have seen those before.
And there's definitely rigging and grip stuff involved, but PTZ cameras is definitely in the future for sure. It's hard to hear us, huh? Let's turn this up. All right. Turn ourselves up a little bit. Somebody commented it was a little hard to hear us.
It was a good two-way shot by Henry. I wasn't sure where he was going to leave the cue ball, if he was just playing a safe up against the 8 ball or what. But he was trying to make his ball, and he left him good. Great two-way shot.
Howard asks, are we planning on streaming any of the APA Nationals in the future? Yeah, we actually streamed all this year, 2016. We didn't do every round because there's, you know, thousands of people playing, but we did the semifinals and finals. So we'll probably move forward with that in the future.
I'm surprised he didn't go for the bank there. I thought he could have went for the bank there.
Somebody's asking if David Royale played. Yes, he played earlier today. He was actually on stream, if I remember correctly. King Henry, line it up. There you go.
Boy, this table's fast, isn't it?
Yes. I'm a three. I don't
know.
I'll
tell you what. I struggled. Tried to draw a ball back about 6 inches in my match and came back about 3 feet.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's a big difference from what you expect.
He was definitely playing that ball in the corner, and that cue ball just kept rolling.
For anybody who's looking for score updates or to see how your favorite player is doing or whether they play next, we actually have something called CompuSport that does our online brackets. You can actually download the app in the Google Play Store on iTunes, or you can actually just go to their website, CompuSport.ca, I believe, is the URL off the top of my head. That way you can follow who's won, who's played when, and whatnot. So. There's actually not a scoreboard for the other. Samantha's asking about scoreboards. There's actually not scoreboards for the other tables.
There's no safe here. You have to try to cut this or back this.
Okay. Ben Connor asked, what rank are these players? Again, this is a non-ranked event. So these guys are playing, you know, there's no points. There's no three-point scoring system. There's no 2 points for the night. None of that stuff. It's simply just the racks. But I would say in league play, these guys are like we talked about earlier.
It's fair to assume that these are all sevens that you're looking at. Sevens and eight ball, nines and nine ball.
Easily.
There might have been an eight that snuck in somewhere, but for the most part, these guys are sevens and nines.
Chanel says that CompuSport does not show the score of the matches going on now. You are correct. You are correct. It does not. It will tell you after the fact whether they've won or lost. But, it doesn't give you live updates, unfortunately. Yeah. Chanel, I hear what you're saying. There's 14 tables playing right now, and we don't have runners for each table. So, and unfortunately, I'll do my best to get you that score. I'll ask if somebody as they're walking by to go grab it, but that's probably the best I'm going to be able to offer you. Ooh, rattled that pocket. You think he hit that a little too hard, or?
Well, he was trying to get on the two, and he did what he needed to do to get on the two, but these pockets are tight, and anytime you shoot on a fast table, a really fast table like this, hard, with any type of English, that cue ball is going to squirt just a little bit more because that felt so fast, and I've noticed a lot of people rattling, myself included, whenever you hit it hard on these fast tables. Need to stay in line. Can't get out of shape because if you try to muscle your way back in shape, sometimes you'll pay.
Turn down the room mic a little bit. There's getting to be a lot more people in here.
Okay, so let's see if he tries to go through the eight and the two, or inside off two rails. It looks like he's going to go inside off two rails, or maybe three rails, maybe four rails. Uh-oh, I didn't talk about that. Nah, he's okay.
So let me ask you a question here. About how many racks does it take? Because, you know, going in, because both players probably didn't get an opportunity really to play because there's only 14 tables in the room, not a lot of opportunity to practice before your rounds, and that's for everybody. Everybody's kind of in the same boat. So you get to the table. First rack's a little, I'm figuring this table out of the rails. How's
the
felt?
Everybody adjusts differently. I always would say that I'm a slow adjuster, but there's going to be a lot of different ways people will go about this. Some people are very meticulous and they line their shots up real carefully, like I do a lot. And some of these guys just look at the ball and shoot. You know, they're field shooters. So you know, everybody adjusts differently, and sometimes it depends on what type of shooter you are.
That's a good question for the chat. Chat, how many racks does it take for you guys to get used to the table? Just throw that out in chat. I'm curious. And also to answer Jimmy Burcham, is there a cutoff to the number of times you can win this tourney and they're no longer considered an amateur? Well, it depends on what you define amateur versus pro. Is it just skill? Is it whether or not you make a living off of it? that kind of thing. I know the APA generally considers if you don't make your living from pool, you're not really considered a pro. And I know opinions, I know that's kind of a polarized topic, so we won't stay on it too long. But
I don't know the full parameters of that either.
I'm pretty sure
I imagine it has something to do with maybe what possible earnings.
Yeah, it's definitely, you have to be making your income.
Certain ranking events, obviously. If you won the U.S. Open, you're not going to be allowed to play in the U.S. Amateur.
Probably not.
No matter what you're making.
Ben Connor says, so you don't have to mark your pocket now? Technically, yes, Ben, but when you get to this level and at this tournament, it's really more of a gentleman's thing.
Absolutely.
They point the pocket. They know these are higher skill players. I mean, actually, and I think in the third streamed match, I think it was Robert Hall, actually wouldn't even make his opponent hit the last two balls if it was really obvious it was going in. And that was also a very polarizing topic. But again, this is a really higher level of pay. They will generally point, but the shot is obvious. These guys are not making balls on accident, by and large. Does it happen? Sure, but generally not on the eight or their nine. So you don't necessarily.
It comes down to respect too.
These guys
respect each other as players, and they're not going to try to win off a technicality. Nobody is going to do that.
Yeah, this is not the place to do that. Because again, there's no prize money. It is to see if your skill. Like
right.
This is about,
absolutely,
am I good enough to hang? And so I don't think people are necessarily. I don't think people want to win that way.
In many regards, if you're the type of player who's going to call that foul, you're not going to be able to make it through this storm. You're not going to be mentally tough to do it.
Right. Because, yeah, one little thing goes your way, you don't feel like it's fair.
If you're looking for that type of an edge, you're in the wrong place.
And but definitely still call your pocket a league night. Super important. You're definitely going to want to do that. You'll see it sometimes at our Masters events, too, at Nationals. Sometimes, you know, a lot of these guys know each other. You know, and I know the year that Ernesto Baiawa and Brian Parks, their teams played against each other. And they may have been, I think it was 2 years ago, maybe last year. There was a lot of mutual respect because, you know, they understand the skill level and that's going on. And actually Ernesto's team won that match, and he actually was, you know, first busted Brian's chops a little bit for losing because they've been friends forever. And then, but then they talked about how the other team got some bad rolls and, you know, and just they were able to take advantage of those bad rolls and, you know, just real friendly, high level of sportsmanship at this event for sure.
A lot of times when somebody slops in a ball or misses the ball and saves their opponent on accident, they'll actually apologize. They'll say, hey, sorry for that roll.
Yeah, I've seen that on the floor, yeah.
There's a great level of respect here between the players. It's not easy to qualify, and they know that, and everybody's here for the right reasons.
Somebody asked, who is the gentleman that Henry is playing? I believe his name is Tom Brodeur. Is that what pronounced that?
I don't know how to pronounce that.
I apologize
if they didn't have me announcing the match.
Gotcha. I apologize for mispronouncing that. One thing about Tom, if you're just joining in, it's actually Tom's daughter's sixth birthday today. So huge shout out to her. Happy birthday. She's actually here watching Dad play.
Why don't you sing her happy birthday right now?
I don't know if the chat wants to hear me sing happy birthday. I don't know if that's what we want.
I don't think he wanted to shoot this off the rail. I think he has to go on the side here because he's on the rail and he's going to have to put forward spin on this, which brings the side pocket into play on the scratch. So he's got to shoot in the side. What was I looking at? I thought I was shooting at the eight ball.
Let's get a different angle here. We've been looking at this angle for quite a while. Let's go back to the middle. Jessica.
I didn't even realize they're playing nine ball now.
We're too busy talking.
I tell you what.
It goes quick.
You can't do two things at once.
Jessica, it was your question. Was Curtis Caldwell here? I would definitely download the CompuSport app. You'll be able to find that information real fast.
Obviously, he was trying to get behind the five there. Didn't quite get there. Henry's got to draw this back to get shape on the four. He's going to have to hit this pretty firm, I think, with a little low outside. So this is another example of that shot that's going to squirt on you a little bit more because of how fast the belt is.
Oh, I bet he did not expect that to happen. That's exactly what you're talking about.
No, actually, I think what happened there was they just put all new felt on these tables.
So that little bit of
outside English that he put on it did not take all that English, and that's why the cue ball didn't come down far enough and he ended up scratching the
side. Gotcha.
Tom's looking good here.
You think this rack is outable, I guess? Is that a phrase that's said?
Well, I thought he was going to come on the other side of the seven, but this works just as well. He basically has a small little draw shot to get the right angle of the eight to come up for the nine. So, and I don't think he got the angle. So he's going to have to hit this little firm with inside English. Or he'll hit it soft and just leave himself a long cut.
Also, now, is that nine frozen against that rail? How much harder is this shot to make if it's frozen? I don't think we can totally tell from the sand, but it looks pretty right on top of that rail.
It's always harder when it's frozen, I think. When the felt is a little more worn and dirty, it's even harder. This felt is so clean right now that I think that helps a little bit.
Gotcha. So he actually played a safety there, putting that cue.
He did not play a safety there. No, he's trying to make that ball.
Oh, he did miss it?
He got lucky there.
Yeah. I know Alvin was talking earlier, like the only way to play somewhat safe is to put the cue down the other end of the table and try, you know.
Well, you want to leave your opponent long if you can't do much else. I don't think he can bank this, so he's probably just going to play a soft safe to get that nine ball on the rail and force him to either bank it or play another safe down table.
I don't think that's what Henry wanted to do, huh?
He was trying to hit it really thin on the opposite side to keep the nine ball on the top rail and let the cue ball come down, but he just hit too much of it.
A little too thick.
It's a mistake I make a lot, too. Sometimes when I'm trying to really thin a ball, very, very thin, I end up hitting too much subconsciously, or whatever. Maybe you're afraid of just missing it and fouling, but it's hard to hit it really thin sometimes.
One thing I got to commend Henry on there, he realized what he did there. Obviously, he didn't want to hit it the way he did it, but he's still smiling. He still smiled at his opponent. Again, just the sportsmanship here is unlike any tournament that I ever go to. And actually, Alvin, who goes to all the tournaments, is like, this is so outside of the norm for what he's used to dealing with at some of the other events. Again, not APA events. Usually all the APA events are pretty chill.
You're not referring to the 14.1 straight pool fiasco with the 10 ball, are you?
I did see that YouTube video.
Oh, my goodness.
But I wasn't referring to that.
Sometimes
I saw that.
You expect sportsmanship and everywhere, and sometimes you don't always get it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That was – we won't talk about who it was or what it was because we don't want to perpetuate it. But, it was quite interesting. And, you know, sometimes it's – and people wonder why the sport of pool gets looked at the way that it does. You know, it's sad to me because it's such an awesome sport. It can absolutely be
such an awesome sport, and it can also be ugly at times. You just got to make sure that you're in the right place.
For sure. Fred Babcock says, TV table brings a lot of pressure. These guys are playing a little tight still early in the tournament. And Fred, we talk about it all the time. You are absolutely correct. I talk to people all the time after they get off the TV table, and they're like, oh, man, that rattles my nerves. And it's really not – it's knowing that everyone's watching. You know, every little move, every little misstep, it kind of get – if you allow
it – fast, it doesn't take much. I mean, if you're just a little nervous and you're having a hard time with that smooth stroke and getting just the right amount on that cue ball – It shows. Your misses are going to be a little bit more exaggerated because it's a faster felt.
Yeah, it's brand new. Chris says, are these guys high-ranked APA players? I'm a beautiful eight and could easily hang or beat these guys. Well, Chris, you are welcome to come out to the event.
Is his last name Bartram?
No, it's Chris Lewis. But he is welcome to go to poolplayers.com/USAM and find out where a prelim tournament is. And he can back up that statement. Well, I'll be glad to put you on stream, my friend.
Okay, well, I expect him to try to come back to the center of the table with this shot. It's possible that he'll play short side position and shoot the eight up in the corner. But now, yep, he's coming back towards the middle of the table. And he's got a pretty much of a stop shot, slide it all the way to the rail and back for the nine. He might even be able to hit it real soft and just leave it in the center of the table.
Oh, that's not what he wanted to do.
I'm not sure what happened there.
I think he just missed.
But it looks like he got a safe out there.
Hey, if you're going to miss like that, right?
That is the way to miss. That is the way to miss. I'm sure Henry appreciates that miss.
Yeah. The King Henry getting his due, right? Todd Barlow says, you do not have to be an APA member to play in this event. You are correct, sir. You do not actually have to be a league playing member to be in this event.
I'm an example of that. I didn't get a chance to play this year. So.
Well, I'm still glad you're here,
able,
my friend.
I was able to pay the little extra non-member entry fee to get in.
It's not even that much,
is
it? It's like
$15, $20.
Yeah, it's not. Just don't go to McDonald's for one trip and you got the difference. I don't know how much you eat at McDonald's, but you know, I got a family of six, so I'm $15 at McDonald's is a cheap visit for me.
Family of six. Well, I'll tell you what, in about a month, I'll be joining you there. I'm going to have a fourth boy.
I think that score is actually accurate back there, guys. I want to say it is, in fact, 4-2. Oh, no. What's going on here? Oh,
wow.
No.
Did he move?
What's he doing?
Did he move the ball?
I don't know. Oh, no. What's going on? No.
Oh, wow.
No.
The room manager is cleaning all the tables because.
Oh, no.
Because
he thought,
a lot of the matches are starting.
Oh, no.
Wow.
No.
Wow.
At least Henry's smiling. Wow. We should probably get a floor manager
well,
out there.
He was definitely hooked or he wouldn't have had time to.
Oh, no.
Wow.
Maybe they'll be able to work it out and they won't need a floor manager. It'll be up to the players to call them out. They need.
Well,
I can't believe that.
Live. Sometimes this happens, and the players just have to come to an agreement on where the second ball was. Obviously, Henry was hooked. We know.
Oh,
that.
Yeah. Yeah, Henry was super hooked.
So there's.
Yeah, guy. Hey, they're talking about whether or not we have a replay. We do not have a replay. Do not come back and ask us for a replay. You know what? I got to give credit to Strokers. He likes his tables clean.
Well,
yep, they maintenance the equipment
that.
Very well. But, yeah, oh, no. Poor guy. You know, he's got to feel terrible. He has got to feel
absolutely.
Terrible.
Absolutely. I mean,
because he
obviously, he had good intentions there.
Right. He really does
and
try to take care
Henry
of the
Henry did
players.
Walk away from the table for a second, so.
It would take me 10 minutes to pull up that shot. I mean, I can if you need me to. We've got a floor manager coming up.
He was obviously hooked, so.
I have to shut down. Do they need me to? It looks pretty much where, to me, I mean, I'm a little.
I know.
Guys, we're going to go off stream for
I'm
just
pretty
a second.
Sure
we're going to get
hooked.
This worked
yeah,
out.
Yeah, we'll just have to.
Thank you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, sorry about that. We got that all worked out. Yeah, live. It happens live, people.
Thought we were going to have to go to the instant replay. Not so instant replay.
Well, unfortunately, this system that we use here doesn't have the just, you know, the really cool instant replay you see on the NFL. So it's took a little bit of a doing, but the players actually worked it out themselves. They came to an agreement of where it was. So
did our viewers see Henry make the jump shot?
Henry did make the shot. I never brought the stream down, so they saw everything that was going on. I just muted us so we could work out the details of what was going on. So.
Again, right there. He tried to hit that hard with English. Oh, look at this.
Wow. Oh, look. You actually hear Henry apologize there. I don't know if he did. He's like, oh, man. So that will bring the score up to 5-2 in Henry's favor. What an interesting turn of events. You know, if nothing else, this is absolutely going to be a story. I'll go ahead and put the – I know a couple of viewers are talking about the scoreboard. Let me go ahead and leave that on there for a second. So, you guys, I'm going to try to put that up a little bit more often for you guys. It is right now 5-2. Henry is leading the racks, and, of course, that's him on the break. Those of you who are just tuning in missed a wonderful moment in streaming. I've been doing this quite a long time, but I've never seen anything like that. Have you seen anything like that?
Not while I was commentating. I've seen that happen.
You've seen it all,
times.
Huh?
I mean, if you play enough pool, you're going to see that three-rail slop shot there.
There's the break.
I don't know if I've ever seen somebody clean the balls like that.
In the middle of a match?
That might be a first. the manager started raking him. He was going around trying to clean tables. Henry came to the table a little bit hooked, walked away, and... They thought they were done. Came back and started.
We're going to make a top 10 moments here at the USA Amateur. That's definitely going to be one of the top 10 moments.
And then Henry came back and made a jump shot after the distraction and ended up getting out the hard way.
Yeah, he did. Henry's shot on that 7 was pretty solid. I mean, that was a good shot regardless because he was absolutely hooked.
I don't know why he shot the 9 so hard. Really don't.
Is it nerves, the table again,
or
he's just
know.
He's just,
I don't know why he shot that.
Just swinging hard today? There you go. Match is definitely not over. 5-2. We've all seen. I think yesterday in the women's event, I think it was Lee. I think, or I'll have to look. Maybe Betty. She was down what, 3 racks, 4 racks. Came back, won the 7 racks. Pleasure meeting you, man. Thanks for chatting with us. We're getting Alvin back in here.
Yeah, I had to take a little break there. I appreciate Mark Mariani hooking us up with some assistance. Let me trade you spots.
For sure.
How about that?
Switch headsets.
That was going to be my luck in the side.
All right, yeah. We're 5-2. I had to make a phone call there.
Dave Glessner says, newbie here, what does hooked mean? Yabba, do you want to explain that?
Hooked. That means that, all right, so he's on the 5 ball now.
You're ADD, bro. You were telling what hooked was.
I'll show you. No, this is what it's about. This is what it's all about. All right, so he's basically hooked on this ball, meaning he can't. What's going on, Kerry?
Go check CompuSport, bro.
I'm not sure.
We don't know who's on stream.
I don't know. Bill knows, or one of them guys.
Sorry, we had one of the players come back and ask us the question.
Why?
It's live.
Kerry should know better than that.
Kerry's been around.
He should know not to interrupt me.
Hey, Victoria.
Okay, being hooked means you cannot hit your numbered ball. So he was on the 5 ball there. I don't know. No, he's on the 3 ball. Excuse me. I can't see on this tiny... Even though this machine is awesome,
but
it's got a tiny
little
screen.
You do need a separate
screen.
Monitor to be able to see it big.
So, anyway, hooked means you cannot hit your numbered ball because you're behind a blocker ball, basically. So you're hooked behind a ball. You're stuck. They say you're locked up or
snookered. I hear that
snookered,
a lot. You've been
right.
Snookered.
Mm-hmm. Snookered. That's the proper term, I believe. So you'll see here... guys saying, oh, he hooked himself. meaning he maybe played the ball but got stuck behind another ball, and that's being hooked. Okay. Nice little stop shot there from Henry in his little poke style. Poke stroke. I like it. He's going to roll forward. Yeah, sure does. He's going to roll forward. He wants a little bit of an angle off the five to get to the six.
He's going
to
shoot that cold, didn't he?
Yeah, he'll shoot the six in the side pocket. He'll go to the left rail to shoot off the rail and out into the center of the table to shoot the seven, and of course, in the bottom right-hand pocket. And, oops, he did not get where he wanted to be. Now he's back cutting this ball. He's going to back cut it into the side. Now he's going to back cut it into the bottom left-hand pocket and go with bottom. He could rattle this ball, so be careful. Nice and easy. He shoots easy, so he should hit this nice. Good. Okay.
Good shot.
Yeah, he just basically turned the ball over, sent it forward, roll. Okay, get the rake. Excuse me, the bridge.
Yep, I can't say. Can't
no, I'm
say
working on that.
Rake.
I'm working on that.
Those of you who don't know, Alvin was streaming with the one and only Jeanette Lee during the ladies' finals.
Sure was.
Referred to the bridge as a rake, and Jeanette was none too pleased.
Yeah, she wasn't happy with
she
that.
She called you out pretty good.
Not the first time. Ladies not been happy with me, but hey, it's okay.
We're going to leave.
It's okay. It's going to be all right.
Aaron Perez asked, where exactly are qualifiers held?
Everywhere.
Everywhere. And it changes
Poolplayers.com/USAMs, correct, and USAmateurChampionship.com has all the information.
Yep.
That's the bottom line.
Go to poolplayers.com/USAM.
Oh, you missed it. Oh, wow.
And fill out that form.
Loving it.
And when the preliminary times come back and begin, we'll make sure you get the information you need to be able to play. To attempt to come to Palm Harbor.
Oh, buddy. I'm loving it. I'm loving it, buddy.
Yeah, that's rack six, or going into, he's on the hill.
Loving it, buddy.
Henry Brodt. On the hill.
Let me update our graphic. Buddy.
See Brian playing there to the left. He's playing against Troy Jones, if I believe. Jones, sorry. Like you, I'm getting a little tired.
Oh, yeah, people think this is so easy.
Aaron Perez says he was just asking where the prelims are, so he knows how soon he can come and win it.
Okay, buddy.
Aaron, right. I love the confidence, man.
You're watching InsidePool.tv, a co-production with PoolPlayers.com, the APA. I'm loving APA. I'm loving it, buddy.
I love it, too. Not only because they pay my salary.
I love it. I love it.
Zach, if somebody walks by, there he's asking the Park Jones score. If somebody walks by and we can send him to the table to find
out. Yeah, we can't do that.
We don't have a way to get that score from where we're sitting.
We can't do that. Sorry. One of these days, buddy, we'll have more than one table streaming.
Yeah.
We're all
a Telestrator, too. That's the next thing.
I got to have a Telestrator.
Telestrator and a PTZ camera.
APA, just get me equipped.
Let's just
get us all equipped. Send me and Steve out there on a worldwide tour.
Randy Woods asked if these are 9-foot or 10-foot tables. These are 9-foot tables, if I'm correct, right?
Yeah, you'll love the streaming life. See, I set up your new job. We're going to get an RV.
Tyler Crocker asked if this isn't bracketed. If you are a 3 in APA, there's a very strong chance you're going to go up against a 7.
Yeah, you're
This does not take skill level into account. It is a non-handicapped event.
No, this is – these are –
You're going to play up against the big boys.
These are fighters
the
here, man. This is real deal here, buddy. Buddy.
Apparently, if you say buddy one more time, you're getting muted by Tony Wheeler.
Man. Wow.
We'll
can't please everybody. I don't care. Mute me then. No, it's 17 hours.
Clint says we're doing a great job.
Thank you.
You're doing a great job.
Thanks. Yeah, I'll stop
annoying
people. You've
been streaming for,
what,
6 hours now?
I don't know anymore. I don't exist in
7
time.
7 hours?
I'm not from this world.
Chat's got you backed up. Now they're saying buddy in chat.
Good, buddy.
We're just having fun with you, Tyler. Nothing but love.
Man.
We're just here watching pool.
I love everybody,
a good time,
dude.
Just like you.
Yeah. Who is this now? Uh-oh. Can't talk. Sorry.
Jimmy Burcham, you cracked me up.
Okay. Give me 1 second here. This is pretty important, actually.
All right, take a break.
Thanks,
Al.
My friend.
So. All right. Yeah, Jeff Turbass says, at least there's no food talk. If you were watching the stream right around noon Eastern, it amazingly does turn right to food. And Strokers in Palm Harbor, where we're at, where the stream's coming from, has amazing food. Alvin is a big fan of the scrimp, as we were calling it earlier. All right, we got Tom coming back to the table here. Kind of looking at the table, trying to figure out what he wants to do. Oh, he just gives the ball. Okay. Doesn't even take a swing at it. Right on. Massé, yeah. Brian, I absolutely will. I will.
Wow, welcome, man. Back,
Alvin.
Back at you.
What you just missed is Tom just gave ball in hand to Henry here.
That call was literally life or death. No, I'm just joking.
You weren't even looking at the monitor.
No, I said the phone call.
Oh, the phone call. Yeah. That makes more sense.
I'm just joking. It wasn't. Okay. Henry Brodt. Old smooth stroking Henry. Oh, look at this little shot. He didn't get where he wanted. He's all right, though.
He didn't look happy with
that
one, though.
He's okay.
Did he get lucky there, or is he's pretty hooked, didn't he? I can't tell from this angle.
Let us have a look at the other angle.
Let's go to another angle.
And he is definitely hooked.
Or snookered, depending on where
yes.
you're from.
Yes. I can hit it. Not very good, though.
It's not a terribly easy shot for him, is it? I mean, as a three, I'm looking at, that's not an easy shot.
No,
I mean,
absolutely not.
These guys are obviously way better than I am.
Yeah, he's gonna put the cue ball, try to put it behind the nine, I guess. Or he might try to send the cue ball behind the 8-7. That would be the safety. Or he's gonna send it. Oh, yeah, he's good.
That looks pretty
there
good
it
to
is.
Me.
Now that is called being hooked big time. That is being hooked right there.
So if you're Tom, what do you do here?
You're done. You
just
can't
hand him
even
the cue
it.
Ball? Or?
Yeah, you rake the balls. Have a Rolando come over and just start cleaning or whatever happened. I don't know.
And you know Rolando. He's like the nicest guy in the world. For those
down
who know, the
over.
Gentleman who came in started
he
cleaning the balls was Rolando.
He can't hit this. Go ahead, sorry.
I was just saying he's the nicest guy in the world with the biggest
he's
heart.
Awesome.
Helps everybody. And I'm sure he
all right, Henry's shooting the cheese for the win. It's gonna roll up on the 5-9 combo. Now he's put a little angle on it, so I don't know what he's doing here. What?
Pocketing a ball, number
what?
One, that's what he's doing.
What? What?
Not
what?
Too bad of shape. Well,
what? Why would he do that? Okay.
We're getting a request from
I guess
the chat
he's so good at banking that he has no problem with this bank. Put it on the other one. That one's good. Okay, he set himself up for a safety. Smart play instead of playing the combo. Combo has a low percentage shot, absolutely. So Henry, who would hand me my rear...
In this
him.
Game, yeah.
He yeah. So he showed me a very important lesson there. So that was – Henry actually played for a safety to set up for a safety the next shot, which is a great move. Noble effort. Noble reward.
Yeah. I actually got to spend a few minutes talking to Tom as he was telling me about his daughter's birthday.
Okay.
He seems a very nice gentleman. Very nice gentleman. Wonderful. Very excited to be here. He actually checked CompuSport and realized he was playing against Henry and predicted he'd be on stream. Which is why he came up and told us about his six-year-old daughter, whose birthday it is today. Shout out to her again.
Yeah, I knew Henry was going to be on the stream, too. Everybody did. He's the champ. He's the man. The man to beat. My horse, Hollywood, won his match.
I saw about a half an hour. Match. He was doing pretty good. I saw him get a 9 on the snap right when I walked by.
Yeah. No, I'm not betting on it, Hollywood. I don't bet. I don't bet. I don't gamble.
That's probably smart.
I'm not that type of person. Not that that's a bad person. It's just not my type.
I work too hard for my money to give it away. Seems to be a kind of a safety battle going on here, huh?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
We need like stream music, like a like Darth Vader, dun 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 dun, the whole time we're doing a safety battle.
That's a good idea. You're pretty creative, man. You're hired. Or actually, okay. You guys hire me.
I don't hire you. My boss hires you.
No, I'm inside pool for life. I'm locked in, bro. Locked
in. Look
at
this. What do you think about that safety, Alvin?
I think that was a very nice roll. That was called the jelly roll. Little jelly.
Steven Peterson asked, do the players know which table is televised? Yes, they do. There's a lot of rigging and there's lights. There's a whole nine. It's very, very obvious.
There's a wiring harness on the ceiling, basically. Mm-hmm. It's not hard to miss or see. Not hard to see. I have to fix one of the lights, too, by the way.
Probably do it in the morning if you want.
Yeah, I should be able to fix it right after this match in about 10 seconds. I'm just going to jump up on the table so everybody will get to see my
I'm going to leave you on stream while
mug.
You like, do that, Alvin.
No, we'll be changing the camera to the APA videos while I'm doing that.
Do you think that's the end of the safety
Nobody
battle?
Nobody ever sees.
That's a makeable ball, right?
Oh, yeah. Rolling shot, 1 o'clock. See, what's he going to do with the 6? He's got to come back down table. This guy's got a crooked stroke, too, so I don't know about this one. Look at that. He was unsure. Yeah, he wasn't. Mm-hmm. He needs to work on his stroke.
That's an even easier shot for Henry.
It's a hand squeeze. You squeeze your hand at the end of the – it's very – look at like Alex Pagulayan, watch him shoot, all the great players. And normally when you walk, your arms want to go in a radius around your hips.
Sure.
Naturally. The right arm, of course, radius is around the right hip, back and forth as you're walking. So when you're shooting pool, your arm naturally wants to follow that.
In that radius, which will come in the front of you, which makes you mess up your shot.
Makes the stroke crooked.
Yeah,
so,
learning stuff today, man. I like it.
Good. So the what I have trained myself to do, not that I'm some great player, but is to go exactly opposite of that radius in the motion, and that really brings a smooth stroke. So
we had a question from Rick Glasscock. Who are the announcers? We have Alvin Nelson from Inside Pool.
There is no Alvin.
And then my name is Steve Alejandro. I'm actually a staff member of the APA.
Wow, man.
Just
Stevie.
Helping out. I'm the guy that does a lot of the photography and video.
Yeah, you'll see him run around. He's got long, flowing hair.
Yeah, long black hair and a smile. I'm
always smiling, always happy. Great guy.
Try to be.
My co-producer for this show. First time co-producer. Hit the hammer.
Hitting the hammer.
All right. We're co-producing this.
Henry, this game's over. You think that 9 in the middle of this is tough? Does he just draw this ball back?
I'm not going to say anybody's out anymore. I've done that, and they've disappointed me. It was very sad. So we'll wait till that ball falls.
Looks pretty good to me.
Mr. Brodt from Laguna, California. Wow.
Yep, and that is
There it is.
The match.
End of the line. We shall return. Thank you,
we
Steve.
We shall. All right.
All right. We'll talk to you all soon. Stay tuned for the next round here on the Billiard Channel. You're watching APA and Inside Pool blasting out across the galaxy. Unstoppable.
And next round is what time?
Everywhere and nowhere.
Next round is at 6?
I don't exist in time. I have no idea.
You just stream.
I'm between the moments, right in the center.
Love
live.
It. We'll go fix your light,
right,
guys. We're going to bring this down for just a sec, and we'll see you during the next round. We'll get that time updated on the screen.
All right.
And yes, we will put on the other camera for you. We want to see one of the matches.
You got it. Nope.
I probably put it on Brian's match.